You're listening to the Hour of the Time. I'm William Cooper. Ladies and gentlemen, good news right off the bat. Number one, we stopped the Conference of States cold dead in its tracks in California. They only got one vote in committee. It is dead in California. Mark California down as a win for our side. Thanks to the Constitution Party, the Hour of the Time, and all of you who responded. Thanks to Senator Charles Duke from the state of Colorado, who, working in close cooperation with the Constitution Party, was in California, in Sacramento, today, along with Aaron Russo, the chairman of the Constitution Party, and California State Senator Don Rogers. We stopped it dead. Dead. Okay, for those of you in Louisiana, here's a number that you can call for information on the Conference of States. Do not call this number tonight. Do not call this number tonight. Wait until tomorrow. Call Jeffrey at 504-525-4369. That's 504-525-4369. That's Jeffrey. And Jeffrey will give you the information that you need and the phone numbers you need to kill the Conference of States in the state of Louisiana. Let me give you the clerk of the House number. This is for the state of Louisiana, 504-342-7259. That's 504-342-7259. The clerk of the Senate is 504-342-2040. That's 504-342-2040. Again, Jeffrey. Call Jeffrey tomorrow, not tonight, for information on the Conference of the States bill in the state of Louisiana. The number is 504-525-4369. Everybody get with Jeffrey, get with each other, and stop it in Louisiana. We're going to stop it all across the country. In the state of Arizona, this is the number at the state capitol. It's 1-800-352-8404. That's 1-800-352-8404. Now, the Conference of States has already passed in the state of Arizona. And so has the call for a constitutional convention, twice, as a matter of fact. Marilyn Jarrett has, and David Farnsworth, our local congressman here, or a state representative here, have co-sponsored HCR 2017. That's HCR 2017. And that is a bill to rescind the Arizona call for the constitutional convention, in fact, both calls. Make sure that you call tomorrow, the Arizona State Capitol, 1-800-352-8404. Ask for extension 5955. That's Tom Patterson's number. He's the Senate leader. Tell him that you want HCR 2017 to come out of committee. You want it to come out of committee on a vote. It's already been passed by 100% vote in the House, in the State House. It's being held up by Tom Patterson in the Senate, in the state Senate, because he wants a constitutional convention. He wants world government. He doesn't believe in this country, ladies and gentlemen. So why is he the Senate leader in the Senate of the state of Arizona? We're going to do something about that. We're going to mobilize a campaign to get him the hell out of there as quick as we can. Arizona State Capitol, 1-800-352-8404. Call extension 5955. That's Tom Patterson, the Senate leader, who's holding up the bill in committee. His fax number is 602-840-8587. Again, his fax number is 602-840-8587. His phone number is 1-800-352-8404, extension 5955. Now, Stan Barnes is the committee chairman. Stan Barnes is the committee chairman. You can reach him at 1-800-352-8404, extension 5288. Once again, 1-800-352-8404, extension 5288. We cannot find a fax number for Stan Barnes. Stan Barnes is the committee chairman where this bill is being held up by request of the Senate leader, Tom Patterson. So, everybody listening, call the Arizona State Capitol tomorrow. Call those numbers, talk to those people, and fax Tom Patterson and tell them you want HCR 2017 to come out of committee for a vote and you want it out now. Don't take no for an answer. In Pennsylvania, there will be a Constitution Party meeting to discuss the Conference of States tomorrow night, Thursday, March 23rd at 7:30 p.m. That's Thursday, March 23rd at 7:30 p.m. at the Villanova Diner, Routes 352 and 30 in Villanova, Pennsylvania. That's the Villanova Diner, Routes 352 and 30 in Villanova, Pennsylvania. Meeting of the Constitution Party to discuss the Conference of States. Remember, we forced them to send it back into committee. It'll be in committee for approximately 3 weeks before it comes out again. So we're making our presence known all over the place, folks, and we're going to fight this battle and we're going to win it. Directions to get there from either I-76 or I-95. Take I-476 to the Villanova exit. Head east on Route 30, 1 mile. The restaurant is on your left. They're going to meet for 6 o'clock. They're going to meet at 6 o'clock for dinner, if you'd like to be there early. 6 o'clock for dinner. It's a nice way to say thank you to Nick, who's the owner, for providing the banquet room free gratis. So if you want, come hungry and eat at 6 o'clock, and if you get there later, Nick will still feed you, I'm pretty sure about that. But remember, the meeting begins promptly, ladies and gentlemen, at 7:30 p.m. Okay, Barnes & Noble Books by Mail has issued a re-release of the following books in paperback. For those of you who are doing your research, we just got this information today. Barnes & Noble editions are hardcover, acid-free paper, cloth spines, and these books are now available once again. The Brotherhood, The Secret World of Freemasons by S. Knight, $7.98. Can't beat the price. The Brotherhood, The Secret World of Freemasons by S. Knight, $7.98. Inside the Brotherhood, Further Secrets of the Freemasons by M. Short, $9.98. Born in Blood, The Lost Secrets of Freemasonry by J.J. Robinson, $12.98. He revealed a lot of things in that book, and shortly thereafter, lo and behold, they made him a deal he couldn't refuse. He became a Freemason and began speaking in their behalf. The Brotherhood of the Rosy Cross by A.E. Waite, W.A.I.T.E., $9.98. The Secret Doctrine of the Rosicrucians by M. Incognito, $5.98. Incognito, my incognito. The Knights Templar by S. Howarth, $9.98. The Knights of the Order by E. Bradford, $9.98. The Murdered Magicians by P. Partner, $7.98. The prices are good, folks. For more info, call or write Barnes & Noble, 126 5th Avenue, New York, New York, 10011. That's Barnes & Noble, 126 5th Avenue, New York, New York, 10011. Or you can call 1-800-242-6657. That's 1-800-242-6657. Or you can fax 1-201-767-9169. That's 1-201-767-9169. Barnes & Noble pays all the shipping and handling unless it's a rush order. And if it's a rush order, then you tell them how to send it, and you pay for that, and they'll send it. And thank you, Michelle. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's get on the road.
My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my father died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside let freedom ring. My native country be, land of the noble free, thy name my love. I love thy rocks and hills, thy woods and tempered hills. My heart is sad to feel like that above.
And ring from all the trees, sweet freedom song.
Let mortal tongues awake, let all that free partake, let thoughts their silent praise the sound, oh God. Our Father's God to thee, author of liberty, to thee we sing.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you were listening to the words very carefully to that song. It's one that's very close to my heart, and I know many of yours as well. I can remember, seems like yesterday to me, that I received a phone call from a man who became a good friend and a man whom I learned literally to love. It's like a big teddy bear, really. To tell you the truth, at any suggestion of hiding the truth or masking the truth or being anything other than honest, he comes unglued. He won't stand for it. He doesn't like secrecy. He and I could have been brothers. We're not. Our religions are vastly different from each other, but in a way, very much the same. He was fed up with the way the federal government was going. and he wanted to do something about it, and he wanted to know if I would be interested in helping him to found a new political party in order to put a constitutionally committed team in the White House to restore the nation. Well, after listening to him for a while and understanding finally that we agreed on almost every single point and have in every conversation that we've had since then, except on some small disagreements on how to go about what we're doing, and we always solved those, we did form the Constitution Party. And it wasn't just he and I, quite a few other people involved in that foundation. And many of you have become members. Those of you who have not, I'm sure, will, when you learn that we are serious and we're the only legitimate and viable alternative to the status quo. I saw for the first time this last weekend a videotape of the very first speech that my friend Aaron Russo, who's the chairman of the Constitution Party, ever made in his life. Not just the first speech about what's wrong in this country, but the first speech he's ever made in his life. This is a man who has brought to the stage some of the greatest music stars who have ever appeared on a stage. He has produced two of the best movies that have come to the screen in many years, both of them nominated for many Academy Awards, and I think they took away some. He had a big, giant award sitting on the table in the conference room where we met this past weekend. He's a modest man. And if you met him in a store somewhere, you'd never dream that you were talking to a multimillionaire. I'm going to play for you now this first speech that Aaron Russo ever delivered anywhere to anyone. And it was at the National Review Institute Conservative Summit in Los Angeles, California. And I think that you're going to find this extremely interesting. And those of you who firmly believe, through some vast misinformation project that you all seem to subscribe to, that all the Jews in this world are intent upon enslaving you and taking over. And I've never understood how you could believe that when they make up less than 4% of the population of the United States. I think you'd better listen very closely to this. I think you should also look at the lists of Jewish organizations and prominent Jewish people who have helped us come out against this Conference of States to defeat it soundly. I think we have to learn to be Americans, and not Jewish Americans, not American Indians, not African Americans, not Aryan Americans, not British Israelis. We either have to be Americans or we're going to lose all of our freedoms. And our common bond, and yes, there is one, is liberty. And I think more and more people are beginning to discover that. So without further ado, may I present to you Mr. Aaron Russo.
There's a way to twist it. Aaron Russo can be said to have broken onto the national scene in 1967 when he moved from New York to Chicago and opened his own club, the Kinetic Playground, where he introduced, promoted, and produced some of the 60s most successful rock acts, including The Who, Led Zeppelin, The Grateful Dead, and The Jefferson Airplane, among others. In fact, many rock pundits consider Aaron to be one of the most important music producers of the 60s. In 1972, he began his 7-year partnership with Bette Midler. And when he turned to feature films, he introduced Bette Midler to motion picture audiences while producing The Rose, for which Midler won an Academy Award nomination. Since then, this creative and enthusiastic filmmaker has produced in the 1983 comedy hit Trading Places with Eddie Murphy and Dan Aykroyd, Teachers starring Nick Nolte, Laura Dern, and Morgan Freeman, and Wise Guys starring Danny DeVito. To date, his films have won 5 Academy Award nominations. Today, he has turned his considerable talents to organizing the Constitution Party to fight what he strongly believes is the federal government's encroachment on the liberties and rights of individual Americans. No one has the right to take away my rights just as I don't have the right to take away anybody else's, he proclaims. The Constitution is the greatest political document ever formulated. The aim of the Constitution Party is to protect it from the ravenous appetite of federal government. Ladies and gentlemen, Aaron Russo.
Hello, everybody. By the way, over lunch, he was all wrong. You can be conservative and be an artist, I promise you. Anyhow, that's not why I'm here. They've asked me here to speak on how movies influence politics. In my experience, it's been the other way around. Usually the politics come first. So that's why I'm going to talk about politics first. Sure, I'd like to get back to the important business of creating films, but in good conscience, I just can't do that. Why, you may ask? Because while I used to be just an American, I've recently begun thinking that I could actually be an American citizen and take individual responsibility and action when something goes wrong. And a lot is going wrong. And it's time to ring the bell. And it's time to wake everybody up to what's happening in our country. I saw a bumper sticker on the back of a pickup truck the other day. It read, "I love my country, but I fear my government." Have you ever had the feeling that your government was treating you less and less like a citizen and more like a subject that they control? Suppose you were watching a 1940s movie. And there's a scene taking place at a bank where a handsome couple's withdrawing their money and the teller says, "Sorry, we have to report all withdrawals over 10,000 Deutschmark. The government demands you fill out this form." You'd say, "Oh, Nazi Germany. What a terrible place that was." But that's exactly what's happening here, right now. But how? And by what authority can Washington do this? The simple truth is that Washington doesn't have the legal authority. Then how do they get away with it, you may ask? By intimidation, by use of force, by threatening jail. That's coercion, and that's tyranny. What's the definition of liberty? Does anybody know the definition of liberty here? The absence of coercion. We're supposed to have liberty in this country. That's what this country is built on. Don't we own our own lives? Shouldn't we be able to do what we want to do as long as we don't hurt anybody else? Do you think what the federal government's doing is permitted under the laws of the Constitution of the United States? Where does it say in the Constitution that Washington can tax incomes that force millions of Americans to work for them from January to June? It doesn't. The Constitution clearly says there shall be no direct taxes on the individuals of this country. Then how did the income tax come into being? They passed the 16th Amendment, or so we all thought. But it was never ratified by the states. It's a hoax. It's a fraud. For 80 years we've been lied to by our federal government. So they take it to court, and what happens? The appellate court says, this is not a question of law, it's a question of politics. So they take it to the legislature, and the legislature, Congress says, this is not a question of politics, this is a question of law. So they bounce it back and forth, they go to the Supreme Court to hear this. And what does the Supreme Court say? We don't want to hear the case. Very easy, just bounce it back and forth and keep sucking our blood. That's what's happening in America today. Now they put a magnetic strip in our currency. Do you know about that? Do all of you know about that? Who doesn't? Let me show you something. Take out a $10 bill or a $20 bill or a $50 bill or a $100 bill after 1990.
Mine has a picture of Dukakis on it. The Massachusetts currency.
Anyway, you'll see, if you hold it up to the right, you'll see a strip in that bill. It has to be after 1990 or $10 and above. Now, if you put a little whip in that bill, you'll see a little white strip come out, and you can pull it out. See that?
Check on my money.
Now, what this strip does is this strip, this has been in existence since 1990. Since George Bush, by the way.
Huh?
This strip allows the government to know how much money you're carrying in your pocket if you're going to an airport, a bus station, anywhere you're going. What is this? Why is this their business? These are your dollars, not theirs. It's your life. When do we turn our lives over to Washington? Why is the Justice Department authorized to kill innocent children, as they did last year in Waco when they killed the brass Davidians? You know they use CS gas. Do you know CS gas is an agent that's banned from war, and they use it on little children? These people were never accused of a crime. They were never charged with anything. They could have picked up David Koresh, Johnny, anytime they wanted to. Where is their accountability? If this would have happened in China, you'd be screaming about the Chinese storming the church and killing innocent children. It'd be worse than Tiananmen Square. But it's America. Not a peep out of the media about the injustice. Think about that. What about this little Vietnamese farmer out in Bakersfield, tilling his field? He ran over a kangaroo rat with his tractor. The government is trying to fine him $250,000. And they're trying to put him in jail for a year. As well as the man who sold him the tractor. Okay? Is this not insanity? Why do we put up with this nonsense? When are we going to stand up and stop it? Why is the government unaccountable for its behavior? I'll tell you why. Because it no longer serves the people. The government are our rulers, and we've become their slaves. We used to have a right to own firearms for sport, target, or in the gravest extreme for personal defense. Even defense against the government. Don't we have a right to protect our children, our families from danger anymore? How much longer do you think we're going to have that right? Not much. Have you seen the new U.S. police badge? United States police badge. Have you seen this one yet? Shades of the SS. I'd like to pass this around. You can just pass it to everybody, so everybody here knows what's going on. It shows that there's now a national police force, United States police force, which is totally against the Constitution of the United States. Now, every session of Congress, they had more punitive laws. And how many of us realize or even think about the effect those laws are having? Is the crime bill really going to do anything about crime? Or is it just another crime against the people? Here it is, the crime bill, right here. Almost 500 pages of fine print. Let me read you a little bit so you know what's in it. I made a copy because it's easier to read. Section 180102, War Crime and Drug Enforcement Task Forces. The Attorney General, in consultation with the governors, mayors, and chief executive officers of state and local law enforcement agencies, may establish a War Crime and Drug Enforcement Task Force in judicial districts that encompass significant rural land. Assets seized as a result of investigations initiated by a rural crime and drug enforcement task force and forfeited under federal law shall be used consistent with the guidelines on equitable sharing established by the Attorney General and of the Secretary of the Treasury, primarily to enhance the operations of the task force and its participating state and local law enforcement agencies. You know what that says? It says they can investigate you, take your money, take your house, divide it up amongst themselves, use it against you, and you haven't been charged with a crime or convicted of anything.
Due process in America is gone. It doesn't exist anymore. This is what you have to understand. And this is what you have to wake up to. And this shall include representatives from many different agencies. The Office of the United States Attorney for the Judicial District, the Federal Bureau of Investigation, the Drug Enforcement Administration, the Immigration and Naturalization Service, the United States Marshal Service, and may include representatives of other federal law enforcement agencies, such as, not inclusive, but such as, the United States Customs Service, the United States Park Police, the United States Forest Service, the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms, and the Bureau of Land Management. Any one of these people can start an investigation against you and take away your life because they choose to investigate you. What about GATT, the General Agreement on Tariff and Trade? 22,000 pages, 365 pounds. That's a free trade agreement? For who? Not for us. No one, not even the congressman or the senators even read it. It would take four senators to lift this. Okay? And yet, the White House is pushing everybody to sign it so they can pass this enormously complex series of laws that are...
You just sit and take this shit.
I'm sick and tired of it. I can't tell you how fed up I am with this government and the way it's running. Our Constitution is based on the firm belief in the sovereign right of the individual. There is no sovereign right of the federal government. That's why our Constitution was written. The Constitution limited the authority of the federal government. But little by little, Washington's taken away our authority, buried it under regulations created by bureaus and agencies whose sole function is taking away our natural rights. Taking away our natural rights and granting us an occasional privilege. Aren't we blessed? You know what really scares them in Washington? The Constitution scares them because it limits them, just like a governor on a car. Like a lot of you, I hadn't read it since high school. Even then, I only read it the night before my civic. That's what they gave me a thing at this time, so I have to leave. But I'm going to finish anyway. They want me to come. I want my Constitution back. That's what my grandfather left here for. To get away from the bloodsuckers who want them to do what they said without question, to obedience. Now look at Washington. They don't care about you or some 200-year-old parchment. Now they don't have use for something as antiquated as the Constitution. They have an ideology. These are the people Jefferson and Madison and Paine and Adams and Ben Franklin warned us against. It's now time to stand up like our ancestors and shout, "Don't tread on me. I won't allow it." You think they'll listen?
No.
I doubt it. Not at first, because that's the arrogance of their power. But unity is our collective strength. So what I hope each of you will do is get a copy of our Constitution and give it a reread, photocopy it, pass it around, fax it, put your initials on it, sign it that you've read it. Send a copy to your legislator, your congressman, your senators. Remind them to read it so they know why they should be thrown out of office. Tell them we won't be bullied and condescended to any longer. We want our Constitution and our country back. And we want to see it run the way it was planned. We want our natural rights and to own our own lives again. To own our own lives. Now, back to filmmaking. There is a film I'd like to make. Actually, I've been looking for the right script.
It starts like a Frank Capra movie. Wide panoramic shot of a long line of refugees leaving Washington. Cut to a close-up on the grimy faces and skewered ties of the displaced bureaucrats and lobbyists. Then we cut to a group of office and construction workers, housewives, teachers, cops, firefighters, doctors, nurses, and even some movie people. Citizens washing down the Capitol steps, washing down the Capitol steps so it's clean. One more time. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom Paine. Aaron Russo.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've been listening to the chairman of the Constitution Party, Mr. Aaron Russo, giving a speech at the National Review Institute Conservative Summit in Los Angeles, California. It's the first speech he's ever given in his entire life. Now, we watched it on videotape here while you were listening to the soundtrack, and I can assure you, he was extremely nervous. Don't go away. I'll be right back.
Oh, beautiful, for spacious skies, for amber waves of grace, for purple mountain majesties.
Gentlemen, the hour of the time is brought to you by Swiss America Trading. All the good people down there in Phoenix who help you get your hands on what you need to protect your assets if what we all know is coming manifests itself. And if it comes sooner and you haven't done anything about it, then you're going to get caught with your pants down, as most people always do in all disasters all throughout the history of the world. And they always say, I wish I had known this was going to happen. I would have done something about it. Well, I guess that's what those people in California said when the big quake hit. And you all watched and you saw that they were not prepared. These are people who live in an area where they know that the whole state could fall off into the ocean at any second. And they were not prepared. They know there's earthquakes every day. They know that every once in a while a real big one comes along and levels a city or two in the state of California. They know, and they still were not prepared. You out there have learned about money from the Hour of the Time and many other sources. You've learned what's happening to the dollar now. You've learned that we really don't have any money. We just have paper, fiat, counterfeit. We don't even conform to the law or the Constitution. And that's part of what Mr. Aaron Russo was talking about. And you're still not prepared. Yeah, that's right. I'm talking to you. You see, I can see right through this microphone, right out the speaker of your radio. I can see you. Sitting there, looking around with that silly grin on your face. You haven't prepared. And you know this is serious, and you keep saying, I'm going to do something about it tomorrow, and you never do. Well, I'm going to tell you, your time is almost up. It's almost up. Tomorrow, you might be wiping the tears out of your eyes and saying, if I'd have only known, I would have done something about it. So why don't you? 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. And that goes for joining a militia. It goes for making sure you have a food supply. It goes for making sure you have water stored. It goes for making sure you have arms and ammunition. It goes for making sure that you have contingency plans and escape routes and know what to do no matter what happens. Earthquake, hurricane, tornado. Tim Lesprance riding in your house on a horse with a pizza for delivery. Whatever. If you don't have a contingency plan, you're going to be in big trouble. Somebody get over here and pound Tim on the back before he chokes to death, please. Annie, Boo, somebody. Call 1-800-289-2646. Do it now, folks. You'll be glad that you did. We're going to open the phones. 1-800-289-2646. 1-800-289-2646. And open the phone.
Things were gone, work for all my life. And I had to start again. It's just my children and my wife. Thank my lucky star to be living here today. But the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where it is dying over my dream. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that fight to me. And I'm glad to stand up next to you, and it meant her still today. But there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
You see, I wonder how many people dialed that number. If you won't be responsible, make the call, I'll trick you into it. That was the number of Swiss America Trading, folks. I know some of you weren't listening at all to my commercial, but you were listening to the call-in number, and I don't know if any of you called that or not. I hope you did. It's good for you. The real number, for those of you who don't know it, is 602-337-2524. That's 602-337-2524. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yeah, Bill, I was semi-lobotomized and dialed the other number before, but I dealt with Swiss American Trading. Do a good job.
Well, good for you.
In any case, I went off to Pennsylvania.
Well, wonderful.
And up there to Harrisburg, you are absolutely right. That is one stately building. I looked around at all that white marble sitting there, and I said, my God, I couldn't even visualize what this building would cost today.
Well, I don't think they could build it today, to tell you the truth.
I mean, that building, absolutely beautiful. It was like 19th century architecture and marble to the max. I mean, I don't know where they got all that marble from. They must have, like, dug a hole in Italy from Italy to Spain or something to find it all.
Well, there's another building that even outdoes that, and that's the post office in New York City.
Well, then as we left that, you know, I took a wrong turn. I was going back to Interstate 81 because I'm coming back to Maryland. And we went past this thing here. It turned out to be some kind of Nor temple or another with a great big obelisk on the other side. I said, well, isn't that special? If you like those obelisks out there, you call our attention to that as much as you can.
Oh, yes. Oh, I don't like them. But I do talk about them as much as I can to make sure that everybody else knows what they are.
Yeah, well, I'd like to add one little thing here. There was an individual I met there named Kevin from New Jersey, and I'm sending him a copy of a United States Note $5 bill.
Good. I know who Kevin is.
Series 1963.
Great.
Yep, he's going to get one.
Okay.
Thank you much, Bill.
Thank you much for calling.
Bye-bye.
602-337-2524 is the number, ladies and gentlemen. And good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, I was wondering if Bill knew anything regarding the phone number that you can call to find out whether or not your telephone has been tapped and if there's any truth to the rumor.
Well, if there was a telephone number that you could call to find out if your telephone was tapped, don't you think, if they didn't know that your telephone should be tapped before, they would after you called it?
I guess.
And if you're not doing anything illegal, why would you care? And if you are doing something illegal, how dumb would you be to use a normal telephone, especially the one in your home? And I'm not trying to make you feel bad. I'm just trying to wake you up. It doesn't matter.
Thanks.
Is the point. Okay? Thanks for calling. Folks, don't get off on these paranoid trips, spinning around chasing your tail. If you're doing something that you don't want anybody to hear, don't do it on the phone from your house. I mean, that's just common sense. And if you're not doing anything that's wrong, what do you care? Now, my phone is tapped all the time. And you know what? I think it's great because they get to hear my conversations and they get to find out what jerks they are and what traitors they are. And I'll bet you that some of them have quit their job because they got an education they don't get where they work. Good evening. You're on the air.
Good evening, Mr. Cooper. I sent you an article from Massachusetts. It's about the National Police Force Training Manual.
Yes.
The FM90-10-1, an infantry guide to combat in built-up areas.
Uh-huh.
Okay, it's about military operations in urban terrain.
Yes.
I forgot to photocopy one small paragraph, and it's the address that you send for a copy of this manual. It's Paladin Press, Department, capital S, capital O, capital F. Post Office Box 1370, Boulder, Colorado, 80306. And the phone number is 800-392-2400.
Would you repeat all that, please?
Okay. If you want a copy of the manual, it is of FM90-10-1. It's Paladin Press, Department SOF, Post Office Box 1370, Boulder, Colorado, 80306, and the phone number is 800-392-2400. And that's the paragraph I missed in case you wanted a copy of it.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
And thank you for calling. Well, you all got some good piece of information there. Yes, I was wondering where that was. 602-337-2524 is the number. Good evening, you're on the air.
Hi, this is Phil from Linwood. I want to call in regards to Bob Fletcher. A buddy of mine socializing with him and says that he's an all right guy.
Yeah, so is Henry Kissinger. Everybody in Washington says he's real swell. Got one of the best personalities they've ever seen. They love him.
Yeah, well, he said you're a drunk. Now, I'm not saying those are my words. Those are his words.
Well, let's hear it from somebody else.
I'm asking you.
Well, why don't you ask Tim? Tim is sitting here. He sees me every single day.
Tim, is Bill a drunk?
No, Bill's not a drunk.
Turn.
Hello?
Hello?
Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. I got to plug the mic in. If I can find it. Back here. There you go.
Hello, this is Tim.
Tim, is Bill a drunk?
No, sir, he's not. I've known Bill for almost 3 years, and I've never known and seen him drunk.
So Bob Fletcher is an agent provocateur then, right?
Well, if he said that about Bill, he's a liar.
No, I said Bob Fletcher. The statement I heard from Bill Cooper is Bob Fletcher is an agent provocateur.
That's correct.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Bill.
You're welcome. But let's talk about this a little bit more. Tim, you've known me for all this time, and you see me every day. Have you ever seen me drunk?
No, I haven't.
Have you ever seen me drink?
Oh, a couple of beers and stuff, yeah.
And how many times have you ever seen me drink in that period of time?
Well, probably four, maybe.
In all that time? Ladies and gentlemen, what the enemy does, if they can't deal with the facts, if they can't deal with the truth, and you should know this, they always attack the person. They use the terms anti-Semitic, they use the word drunk, they use the words drug addict, In fact, somebody called me tonight and said that someone called Tom Valentine and said that I was on drugs. Am I on drugs, Tim?
Not that I know.
Have you ever seen me take any drug?
Negative.
Well, you have, too. You've seen me take Advil for the pain in my leg and my back.
Well, yeah, but I don't consider that a drug.
Well, no, most people wouldn't either, but I want to make sure that this is a strictly honest conversation here. You have seen me take Advil for pain, right?
Yes, I have.
Okay, does Advil affect my personality?
No, it doesn't.
Does it affect what I do?
No, it doesn't.
Do I run into telephone poles when I drive?
No, you don't.
Tim, would you lie to cover up for me?
No, I would not lie. Myself, I have too much of my word with others to lie and cover up for another person. As a lot of you folks know that know me and have met me, I've never lied to anyone. I don't have to lie. I can tell you a story today, and I can tell it 10 years from now. It's the same thing. So, Bill, I've known, like I say, almost 3 years. I've never seen him drunk. He's not a drug addict. Yeah, he does take Tylenol, Advil for the pain in his leg where it was amputated. And it does, when you stand on it a lot, cause a lot of pain. So if you consider that drugs, that's crazy.
I never take Tylenol, only Advil. Tylenol screws with my body temperature somehow, and I can't take that. So anyway, thank you, Tim.
Yeah,
and I want to thank that caller, although I know he had other motives. I want to thank the caller for calling and asking that question so that we could get this out in the open and everybody could hear from somebody else what the truth really is. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill. How you doing? My redial thing is killing me.
Well, I'm sorry, but this is a very popular line to be calling on, you know.
Ah, well, sorry, it is. Listen, man, you're doing a great job. You know, I called you a few months ago, and I mentioned that I was a chiropractic student, and I gave you an excuse that I didn't have time to do research and all that nonsense and basic bull binky. Well, even, you know, I mean, it's crazy curriculum and everything, but I've been researching some of the stuff that you've been doing. In fact, I called and ordered your book, and I ordered a few other things on the Waco Massacre and all that, and I'm trying to put it all together. And basically, I just wanted to say thanks a lot, man, because you're really, really helping us out, those of us who are actually interested in this. I mean, and it's funny that you say that it's not a conspiracy, because one of the things that I don't hear a lot of people address is that it's a situation where nobody really seems to care. I bring this up to my friends and my family, and they all think I'm losing it, you know? They all think that it's just a matter of...
That's how we got to this situation that we're in, and that's why this sedition has gotten so far. It's never been secret. It's always been out in the open. Most of it, in fact, has occurred on the floor of Congress.
Exactly. You know, is the problem, you know what I think it is, too? You'd mentioned something about replacing rights and freedoms with social services. And I think if people, especially the me generation of today, the young people of my age and younger even, are all concerned with their MTV, their Beavis and Butthead. Can they do this? Can they do that? Can they get away with this? Can they spray paint? Especially, I'm in New York City. And here, it's like, you know, basically, the morals of the society is so far deep into the cesspool that there's, it seems like people aren't even interested when you tell them these things, because I don't think that people want to face it. I mean, I stay up nights and worry about these things. You know, I went up last weekend to take national board, which is a really stressful test, you know, really crazy. But I get more stressed out sometimes thinking about the things that are going on in this country. And to all these people out there who are saying they don't have time to do this research or they don't have time to do it, I take 30 credits a trimester, which is almost 80 credits a year, all right? And it's all science and it's all intense. And if all I'm trying to say is that if you people out there or any of you listeners who are listening to Tom Valentine and all the other watered-down stuff, if you think you don't have time to do it...
That's the radio version of Beavis and Butthead.
Exactly. I mean, these people, they don't realize. I mean, they don't realize what it takes to do research is not that much, and the penalty for not finding these things out for yourself is that you're just going to be a victim of all these secret societies.
That's right. That's 100% correct.
You know, and so many people I hear call you up, and you know, I don't want to take anything away from
you. But you know, it's fashionable to be a victim these days. People are taught to be a victim and like it because it gets them special protection in socialist circles.
Absolutely. Well, you know, it's funny that you say that, too, because the social services that are being given, it's almost like if you just keep your mouth shut If you keep your mouth shut, you get this. If you keep your mouth shut, you get that. I mean, you were with the Office of Naval Intelligence.
That's right.
But you could have, you know, you could have retired with probably a really nice pension, or you could have been making up into six figures, but you saw what was going on, and you gave it up.
That's correct. I could have stayed in five more years and retired on a very, very comfortable salary at the expense of all of you listening.
Exactly. I mean, I you don't get me wrong. I listen to a lot of Christian stuff on the radio too, and I like, you know, I like a lot of different broadcasts. But really,
I listen to all that stuff too. In fact, believe it or not, I even listen to old Brother Stair once in a while.
Yeah, I like him too. I actually like him too. But the thing is that, you know, as far as pure unadulterated information, I mean, anybody who's just tuning into this broadcast for the first time, I recommend this broadcast to everybody. My friend upstate listens to it, and we just send each other tapes all the time, and it's really, really unadulterated information. You know, I've read a lot of different materials about the secret societies. In fact, I'm in New York City, so I'm going to head down to Barnes & Noble on my way home from school tomorrow, and I want to try and pick up some of that, if not all of it, if they have it in stock, because this stuff is fascinating. This stuff is incredible. I mean, the fact that these people are doing this to us,
yeah,
and that they want to enslave us into their idea of what they believe freedom and democracy should be.
And religion and everything else.
I mean, people 100 years ago, people would have been out in the streets. Now they're just like, hey, give me my welfare check. Give me my welfare check. I mean, 100 years ago, we would have been out in the streets protesting. We would have been nuts. We would have marched on Washington with guns and not even thought about it.
That's right. Listen, we're out of time.
Sorry about that. Have a good day. Have a good night, man. Thanks a lot.
Thank you for calling.
All right, bye.
He's absolutely correct, ladies and gentlemen. You know, I had somebody call me the other day and said, I'm not going to listen to you anymore because you're not a Christian. In the first place, the person doesn't know what I am. Second place, it's none of their business. And the third place, if that's how they judge who they're going to listen to, they're lost. They're lost. Most of the knowledge in the world is not written in Christian books, nor can you hear it on Christian broadcasts or in a Christian church. And for those of you who do understand, have been listening for a long time, I am a Christian. So the person was 5,000% wrong. I may not have agreed with their particular doctrine. I don't agree with a lot of people's doctrine, but I'll fight to the death to allow them to have that doctrine. You could bet on that. You can take it to the bank. Good night, folks. God bless each and every single one of you. Just in case some of you are laboring under misconceptions out there about what is and what isn't and who isn't, just understand that the very best con men in the world are the ones you like the most, the ones you love, the ones who would never do anything wrong to you. If you don't believe me, ask the victims of these people. What makes a good intelligence agent? The fact that no one would ever dream or believe in 100 million years that he could or would be an intelligence operative. What makes a good spy? The same thing. You people better wake up. You really better wake up. Remember, everybody loved Barabbas. They loved him so much that they set him free and crucified Jesus Christ.
That make us free. And the more we remember the way we began, the closer we get to the best we can be. Whatever time we forgot his worth, all the troubles and the scars, if we lead to the shield in the sky full of hope and the flag is filled with stars. America, America, and the dream. America, America.
we fall. And facing the fog and the factory mountain, you think there'd be no fog at all. And the name of the song is the name of the team, and it's really good. Amen.